Okay, now we're to the step where we want to get our gold back out of the mercury. This is the part where it gets dangerous. We're going to put nitric acid on our ball of amalgam. The fumes coming off of that are deadly. The liquid that is in the pan is deadly. The mercury will become suspended in the nitric acid. You get that, you put your fingers in it, it will be readily absorbed into your body. Not only will you get the mercury in you, you also get the nitric acid, which is also a poison. So you want to make sure that this is done outside. You don't want your pets around, your kids around, anything else. Now the fumes that come off this, if you have a gentle breeze, stay away from it while this process goes on. The warmer the weather is, the quicker it will react. On a cold day, it'll take a long time. On a hot summer day, it's a matter of 30 seconds. Today, right now, it's probably 65 degrees. I have a light breeze, which is, today's perfect. I like to do it in a black gold pan because that heats your liquid up. And so what I do at this point is you want to clear your spot, put your pan on a bit of an angle, set it on something so it sits at a little bit of an angle, so all your, you don't want to have to fill your whole pan up. On an angle, you can just put a little bit on one side, pour in your nitric acid, let the procedure start, and then just get away from it. You know, don't stand around, don't watch it, don't take any chance. If you can smell anything, you're breathing the fumes. So you want to make sure nitric acid has a very distinctive odor. So after you pour this on, if you can smell that odor, you're breathing in toxic fumes. So you want to get away. Okay, what I've done here is I got a small block of wood. Set my pan on there. I've poured out all the water because you don't want the water to dilute your nitric. And so now we're going to put the acid in. And I'm going to leave the camera running so you can see the results. Okay, that reaction you're seeing is the nitric dissolving the mercury. The mercury will become in solution in your acid. And when that process is all done, we will have our ball of a sponge gold, for lack of a better term. It'll be dirty, and we still have to clean it. Okay, well, I'm going to shut this camera off and go get a drink while this is going on. Okay, it's been approximately, I'm guessing, 5-8 minutes. Actually, I'm kind of kicking myself for not actually timing this. But as you can see, the reaction has slowed down considerably. But it's still reacting, so it's not done yet. So we'll just let it continue and until we get absolutely no more fizzing or any, I don't know if the camera's picking it up, but you can see a brown gas coming off that. That is, you do not want to breathe that. If you smell any odor whatsoever, get out of that area. Okay, we'll be back in a minute. Okay, now you can see. Now I don't know if the camera's picking it up or not. The bubbling has stopped, but there's still a little bit of fumes coming off. So that means we still got a reaction going on. So we want to give it just a little bit more. You got want to wait till everything's pretty much just dead calm. And one thing I wanted to mention before I forget is when you're done squeezing the gold out and cleaning your chamois, you rinse your chamois off in clean water and hang it up and let it dry. But be aware that that chamois is now contaminated with mercury. So you don't want to use that for anything other than this process. What I do with mine is after it's dry, I fold it up and I put it in a plastic bag and put it away and just save it till the next time. But you want to make sure that you don't leave that out where the kids can get a hold of it or somebody use it on the car or whatever, because it is contaminated with mercury now. There will always be a little bit of mercury left in that. Okay, well, we're going to let this go for a little bit longer. It's starting to clear up, so I think we're pretty much done. I'm going to run off and do a few chores, and I'll be right back. Okay, as you can see, the all the reactions pretty much done. The liquid is cleared up to where you can actually see the material on the bottom. So that's a good indication that it's no longer boiling and working there. Now, to give you a reference point, the temperature right now is 70 degrees, and this process has probably been 20 to 25 minutes. Okay, now the next step we want to do is we want to get our gold out of there. And this is where you have to be very, very careful. That solution is very toxic. So you don't want to get that on your hands. Not only, like I say, not only do you have mercury in suspension, you also have nitric acid. They are both toxic. So what you do is you pour the nitric acid off very carefully into another container, either plastic or glass. Okay, now we'll take our acid, and I'm going to pour it into a glass jar. Normally I don't use glass because I don't want to take the chance of breaking, but the glass will allow you to see the next process better. So you very carefully pour that into the glass. Getting all that liquid out. And now, like I say, be aware that this is very toxic. Okay, keep pan under that. Okay, what we have left here is our gold. And there's probably some lead in there. At this point, we can go ahead and put a little bit of water in here. Now, in a small quantity like this, it isn't an issue. But what I do is I take a little bit of water, pour it on there, and that will neutralize that acid real quick. Now we can take that little bit of water, you don't want much, and we can just pour that in with the rest of our acid. Okay, be very careful. Okay, now what we have left here is our gold. Make sure we get all that acid out of there. Okay, so right now we're just going to set this off to the side. Our main concentration is going to be this. Now this, like I say, is very dangerous. So now we need to get our mercury back out of that acid. Okay, now we have acid with mercury in it. We want our mercury back, and we need to get the mercury out of that acid so we can dispose of it properly. So to get that out, we're going to take a small strip of copper. It can be copper wire, it can be a strip of copper, it just has to be all copper. And you're going to put that in that acid, and that is going to cause a reaction. Okay, now I don't know if you can see that or not, but there is a reaction going on between the copper and the acid. And what the acid is doing is eating at the copper, but it also, when the copper becomes clean, the mercury is attracted to the copper. So same as before, we just let that keep going until there's no longer any reaction. Okay, we'll be back in a bit. Oh, and as usual, don't breathe the fumes. And you know, like I say, this is still a very dangerous product we have right now. Okay, now while we're waiting for that process to work itself out, I'm going to take our gold, rinse it with fresh water. Want to rinse it several times with fresh water, make sure it's all nice and clean, and then I'm going to put it in a bottle, and then we'll go to the next step with the gold. Okay, I've got my fine gold in the little tray here. Now, one thing I want to be sure to cover is when you're moving this around, after you rinse it and you transfer it to the bottle, it's almost impossible to transfer it without touching it. So what I do is I wash my hands with like a dish soap, and then I leave a little soap on them. So that, because you got some gold in here that is just super, super fine, and it'll float right out when you're rinsing it. So you gotta be real careful. So now what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna transfer this into my jar. Okay, now we got our gold safe and sound in our bottle. We'll go back and take care of the last of our chemicals here so we can clean this all up, and then we'll go back inside and clean this up. Okay, as you can see here, our reaction is pretty much done. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna take our piece of copper out with the mercury on it and just drop that into fresh water. Rinse that off. Now let me change this camera a little bit. Okay, now we can take this copper strip now and just squeegee that mercury right off. And you can see right here, we have a mercury back in there. Now what I like to do is I like to take this, throw it right back in the acid for a little bit, and make sure we got all of the mercury out of there. So what we're gonna do now, we're gonna bring our acid back and we're gonna just throw this in the acid and wait a few minutes, and then we'll pull it out and do it all again. Okay, we're gonna pull that out, and then we'll throw that in clean water. There we go, now you have to see what's going on. Okay, we'll clean that off and we'll do the same thing again. We'll see if we can get any more mercury off that. And it doesn't look like we're getting anything else off that, so we're just going to throw that underwater. Now, one of the things I like to do to check to make sure we got all the mercury out is I'll take a clean copper strip and I'll lay that into mercury, let it react for, or into the acid, we'll let it react for a few minutes and pull that out, rinse it off, and look, and it's just clean copper. There's no mercury on it. So we've pretty much got all the mercury out of that solution now. And now, the mercury that we have in here, we can take that mercury and put it right back into our jar with the rest of our mercury, our strip here, we want to take that and put it in a jar underwater, and we'll save that for the next time. Now, after a while, the acid is going to eat that copper strip completely away. So, you know, you can use it once, twice, maybe three times, but it'll get so thin that you can't really utilize it anymore. Okay, now, let's move on to the next step. And then, the next thing we want to do is we have water here with our mercury in it. This water's got a little tiny bit of acid, so we'll just go ahead and we'll pour that in with clean water I got in this pan. Now we want to make sure we don't pour our mercury off. Okay, now we're going to set that off to the side. Now we're going to take our acid very carefully, we're going to pour that into the clean water. Rinse the jar out. Okay, then you want to rinse this out in good, clean, fresh water. And what I do is after I wash it out, I keep reusing. I keep all my chemicals stored in one spot, so I just keep using the same things over again. Okay, now we have diluted acid in here. Now, what we need to do, this is still highly corrosive, so what we need to do is neutralize it. And to do that, we just use plain old baking soda. Now, never dump the baking soda directly into the acid because you will have a violent reaction. You want to dilute it out and then just start out with just a little bit. Okay? You want to make sure you're not going to have a violent reaction. We got to dilute it out enough. And what we'll do is we'll just pour some baking soda in there. Let it react. And then I wait till it dies down. And then I'll put a little more in there till I get no reaction. And it'll sort of clear up. One more thing I wanted to cover real quick was that chamois. What I do with my chamois, show you here, is I mark it that it has mercury on it. And then, like I say, I put it with all my chemicals, all my stuff I use in this process, even right down to my tweezers. I don't use these tweezers for anything other than this process. That way, all your contaminated material are all together, all in the same spot, and they're less likely to have an accident that way. But make sure that chamois that you mark it, so that somebody come along, they don't grab it because it does have mercury in it. Okay, now you can see that the action's pretty much quit. Water's starting to clear up. So what I do to test it is I take some clean copper and I just lay it in the solution. And now if this is still acidic, you know, if it's still, the acid's still active, it will very quickly react to the copper. And I see no reaction at all. Now pull this out and see there's no difference between where it's been in the acid and where it hasn't. So we pretty much got this neutralized. Okay, now you can take this, pour it in a plastic container. Do not use glass, use plastic. And if you have a recycling center in town that, you know, will take toxic chemicals, you mark the container so they know what it is. It's diluted nitric acid that's been neutralized with baking soda, and turn it in. Or what I do with mine, since there's nothing in here now but copper, which is not a toxic chemical, I just pour mine down the drain. And make sure I rinse it with plenty of water afterwards. Okay, so now we're going to head inside and show you how to clean that gold up. Okay, I've put our gold in a little tray here so you can get an idea of what it looks like. And as you can tell here, it's not very good looking gold. It's real dark from the acid. So what we're going to do now is we're going to clean this up. Now I've taken this out of the glass bottle and we're going to put it into a plastic bottle. This regular plastic bottle here, you do not want to use glass for this next process. You want to make sure you use plastic. Okay, we now have all our gold in the plastic jar. Now the next thing we want to do is we want to pour all the water off. Want to get as much water as we can out of here. Okay, now we're going to take our coin cleaner and you pour just a little bit of coin cleaner in there. Now keep it over the pan so you don't make a mess. And I've poured about that much coin cleaner in there. Put the lid on. Hold your container on both ends. And this is why we're going to use plastic. Better get the lid on that so I don't make a mess. Is we're going to take this now and just shake it up. This is why you don't want to use glass, because glass, you stand a chance if you got a little nugget in there, the glass can break. And you want to hold it on both ends, just make sure the lid can't come off. You give that a little bit, shake it a while, and then we'll let it set for a second. And then we'll be right back and see the results. Okay, now, I was letting that set, I went and put some clean water in our pan here. We're going to shake this up a little more. This method, you got to kind of guess. You may have to do it, once, maybe twice. Because once you start going, you can't really see what's going on in here. So what I like to do, and you got to keep the pan with water, because as you shake this, you're going to get that really, really fine gold up around your lid and stuff. And you rinse everything off in the pan, that way you don't lose your gold. Now I'm going to pour our cleaner off into another jar here. And then we can rinse this out a little bit. And it looks like we're pretty good, so I'm just going to dump everything in the pan. We're just going to rinse it all off into the pan. Make sure we get all our real fine gold out of there. Okay. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this pan, I'll dump this out, put some clean water in here, and we'll take a look, see what the finished product is. Here we have our finished product with the water drained off. Now, I'm going to try to get this up here. See, we got nice clean gold now, but if you look over here on the edges, you can see just the super, super fine gold that's in there. So you can see it right here. It's just super fine gold. And this is why when you're cleaning it, rinsing stuff out, like I tell you, do not want to put your hands in the water, because that super fine gold will float right out. That stuff is real hard to maintain, to move around. So what we're going to do right now that we got it all clean and shiny, we're just going to let it dry. Okay, well, we got our gold here. It's all nice and dry. Now, we got to transfer it onto the scale. when you have this real fine gold, that could be a bugger. So what I do is I take a piece of paper, just fold it in half. And you can lay that down, turn your gold over, just tap it out on the paper. Now, I'm going to try to get a close-up view here. And you can see here we still have real, real fine gold in the pan. And that is almost impossible to move around. You can see it right there. At this point, I don't really worry about that because there's not enough there to warrant the time to mess with it. But the bright side is you always have a little gold in your pan. Okay, so now we have our gold in the paper here. I got my little tray on the scale and I got it teared out. So we can now very carefully pour our gold on the tray. And looks like we ended up with 1.5 grams. Or 0.95 pennyweight. So we almost got a full pennyweight. Not bad for finding gold in the middle of winter. Well, a pennyweight worth of gold in the middle of winter is okay in my book. That's one of the reasons I like waiting until, it's just horrible weather. You can't go out and look for gold. Well, it gives you the opportunity to find some gold. Now, this procedure that I just showed you, if you go by all the safety procedures and you have a healthy respect for the chemicals and how dangerous they are, it's a pretty safe procedure. You know, you take your time, be careful, and it's really not that bad. Now, myself personally, especially when I had kids at home, I keep all my chemicals, all my contaminated stuff, my nitric, my mercury, all that stuff, all in one spot, all locked up in a container. That way, two things, I know where it is, I don't got to find it. And secondly, I don't have to worry about any accidents happening, somebody getting in there that doesn't know what it is and how dangerous it is. Now, with that said, hopefully here, spring's not too far off, and we're going to be heading back up in the hills here, hopefully shortly. And so, if you enjoyed the video, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. That way, when I do get up in the hills and start doing some more treasure hunting and prospecting, you'll get notification that I've actually got up in the hills. So until then, you have a wonderful day. Today we're going to today I'm going to show you how I clean my okay now so we'll just fire up and we're back at it again.